Recently, we put together more formally a vaccine steering committee. In fact, in April, the vaccine steering committee was put in play within the state of California, CDPH, Department of Public Health. We now have advanced a logistics task force working here at the Office of Emergency Service. For the last few months, they have been coordinating with federal, regional, local, partners to look at logistics side of how we implement and actualize our vaccine plan. California today is launching now more formally a scientific safety review, a work group of 11 individuals, experts in their field. These are top health experts that will independently review any FDA-approved vaccines. Question I often get is, are you going to take someone's word for it as it relates to vaccines? Of course, we don't take anyone's word for it. We will do our own independently reviewed process with our world-class experts. These experts, again, will independently review and monitor any vaccine trials to guarantee the safety, to guarantee the equity, and to guarantee the transparency of the distribution of our vaccines. For just full disclosure, the transparency was put forward through guiding principles that we put out in a document, a vaccine plan that we submitted to the CDC last week. In return for submitting the vaccine plan, the state was afforded some $28.86 million of federal support that we will utilize with our partners here throughout California, meaning that $28, almost $29 million will go to support our efforts at the state level and also support local efforts in terms of advancing our vaccine planning efforts. Bottom line, though, is the first phases of vaccine will likely be limited in terms of availability. Questions abound. When do we anticipate or expect the first vaccines to be made available? There are some audacious stretch goals that you've been hearing that have been advanced out of Washington, D.C. These limited doses will be for a limited number of people, and we don't anticipate mass availability until 2021. The question for all of us is that in the first quarter, second, or third quarter of 2021? My answer to my own question is yes, yes, and yes. It just simply depends who you talk to. Those that are more optimistic, Q1, those that are more realistic, middle of 2021, those that are on the spectrum being a little more pessimistic are looking at Q3 of 2021. But it's 2021 for, as they say, you and me.